Okay, welcome everyone to the second of our four masterclasses here from the Kletter Hotel. This is at the Tradewise Gibraltar Chess Festival, our 12th year. And on my left, our very special guest, and a big round of applause please for Mr. Vasily Ivanchuk. Vasily, what are you going to show for us tonight?
So, after some hesitation, I decide to describe today my first candidate match. It was in Riga in 1991 against Leonid Yudasin. So it was five games. I win with big score, 4.5 against half. But as I will show, score doesn't mean that fight was so easy. It was many interesting moments. So start from the first game. So d4. Okay. Nothing special. Once I read that Robert Fischer wrote that I never played d4 for principle. Well, I don't know why, what is argumentation of principle, but especially in this match, I want to tell something special about this move. Because I was in good shape, I prepared a lot before this match, and I made a lot of work with e4 also, and probably if situation in match was a little bit different, I would try e4 for this match. But my second was Felix Levin. Now he lives in Germany. And he told me, Vasily, Yudasin is very strong in hedgehog structure. So your best choice is to play d4, because if you play e4, after c5, for example, knight f3, e6, d4, takes e6, a6, e6, and a6. For example, Kahn system, it's already hedgehog structure. If you will play, for example, c4 first move, c5, and then without d4 it's difficult to fight for initiative, after d4 hedgehog structure is very likely. So your right choice is d4 and avoid hedgehog structure.
Interesting.
So, and he was completely right. So d4, knight f6, c4, e6, I played g3. c5. That period I played more often knight f3, but after knight f3 takes and queen c7 is possible.
Hedgehog.
Yes. So hedgehog or a6 or queen c7. So, wrong choice, so d5. takes, b6, d6, classical Benoni. Okay, black has more sharp option b5, but okay, Yudasin didn't play this. So d6, knight c3, bishop, nothing special, a6, a4, knight bd7. Okay, now it's according to modern theory, the most popular line for white is bishop f4. So I played knight d2. And now, of course, the most popular line for black is rook e8. Okay, many players made this move without special thinking. But okay, what can I understand this position? So white played knight d2. According to, for example, Paul Morphy, very strange move, because it's bishop f4 is much more natural to development. Okay, knight d4, white wants to put knight on c4, but at the moment, knight c4, it's not a big threat, because black has knight b6, for example, if black plays some move. But black should be careful. If rook b8, knight c4 now is strong. Okay, of course, rook b8 is not good, because if knight b6, knight d6 takes and bishop f4.
Paul Morphy moves,
yes.
Bishop f4.
Yes, so rook is not so good. Positionally in on b8, rook is good, but for tactical reason, especially in this position, not so good. So rook e8 is completely normal move. But you doesn't choose queen c7, more rare move, but also completely possible, because sometimes black can push c4. Sometimes e8 square can be useful for the knight. And if after knight h5, f5, rook can be useful on f line. So queen c7 has some reason.
I think Yudasin was also quite an expert in the Benoni, no?
Yes, he is expert, but according to Levin, not so big expert like in hedgehog structure. So I played, so now it's clear that after knight c4, black will respond knight d6, and his rook much better on a8, because there is no trick knight d6, bishop f4, and white cannot achieve anything special. If, for example, knight a3, bishop d7, if a5, knight c8, and black is okay. So queen b3, very concrete idea. So now it's clear that white want to play knight c4, because square b6 is attacked, and black need to do something against it. That's important, that drastic measures is not so good for black, because if knight e5, I play directly f4. Oh, of course, more positional h3 and then f4 also possible, but f4 looks more direct, and there is no reason not make it. Of course, now if knight moving to g4 or d7, white plays knight c4 with much better position. If black want to create some tactic, c4, queen b4, it's very good. To control squares b6 and c5, it's possible to check. So a5, queen b5. And now another important moment, that if bishop d7, white queen has no moves, but after take bishop f5, it will be three pieces against queen. And in this position, it's completely clear that white is much better, probably even winning. Mm. And also important here that if black tries knight g4, takes with threat bishop d7, white has rook f4, and if bishop d7, rook c4, just in time. Yeah. So it doesn't work. It means that in this moment black should play accurate move rook a8, standard move, and if knight c4, the most natural approach, knight e5, knight b6, rook b8, and then to go with some knight to d7. It depends how white to play. Okay, it's completely playable position for both. Knight e8 he played. It doesn't look so good, because knight c4. Now I want bishop f4. Rook b8, another very dubious, okay, frankly speaking, it's bad move. So much better was play knight e5, but also knight e8 is quite dubious. Rook e8 look much more strong. Knight e5 was correct, knight b6, rook b8.
Vasil, sorry, could I ask one question? What was your personal score with Yudasin before this match? You must have played each other before.
I played only two games, it was draws, two draws.
Before this, okay.
Okay, so it was the better. And now bishop f4, the most natural, to avoid knight d7, because if knight d7, knight c4 is unpleasant. Okay, white is better, but it's playable position for black. They can try f5, then rook f7 somehow. So rook b8, another bad move. And after bishop f4, white is clearly better. But okay, it's far from winning, but he played b5. It's it's blunder. Like he explained that after the game, it was a big miscalculation. He considered variation takes takes, knight takes b5 like impossible for white because queen b7, knight a3, queen b7, knight a3, knight c7. So he considered knight a5 before knight e4 with more or less complicated game. But then after I took on b5, he realized that after taking and queen b7, I have simple move rook e5 and black has no pawn and has nothing good in position. So of course he was very disappointed after such mistake, and objectively situation it's extremely bad for black. Knight e5 he played. Bishop takes, takes b6. Bishop f6, now rook a3. Well, of course, white has now many good ways. Knight a4, I just protected pawn. Bishop d7, takes, takes, rook b3. Now, probably was better for black queen b6 to play, queen a6. For example, if queen a6. Takes, takes, bishop f6 with some chances for draw, but of course it should be winning for white. But after queen c7, queen a6, bishop f6 looks very natural move to activate bishop, but bishop h3. And now everything is finished because he has no defense against queen b5, rook a7. Suddenly his queen is terrible. Bishop g7, queen b5, he resigned. Rook e7 is coming. So match started very good for me. Now we will start second game.
Okay.
Okay. Now I can.
So this candidates matches, it was the best of 10 games or 12 games. Do you remember what the format was?
10 games because I 4.5. No, 8 games. 8 games.
Okay.
Format. Mm. 4.5 was enough. So, second game. E4, C5.
Do you think he was nervous in the first game? Why did he play so badly? Do you think?
Yes, maybe he was nervous. Maybe he was surprised with queen B3. Because it seems he played queen c7 before, but his opponent played h3 or something like this. So, but okay, even in the board he could play much better. So b5, it's a terrible miscalculation. Okay, it's sometimes this happens with everybody.
Sure.
I am not an exception. This. So bishop c4, knight f6.
This was your first candidates, or probably for him as well, the first candidates match for both of you, I guess, yeah?
Sorry?
Your first candidates match.
Yes, yes.
And for him also?
Yes, yes.
For sure.
Yeah. No, not last. and next cycle he played match against Kramnik and lost this. But he played again. He was qualified again.
Twice, yeah.
Yes. Mm. So this three. Okay, this three.
Okay, so you're black. So this is game two.
Yes, I'm black. As I remember, during the preparation, I focused more attention with sharp line with knight g5, d5 takes, knight e5. So, but he choose more solid line. Bishop e7, castle, castle, c3. Okay, c3. According to modern theory, it's not the best move because after d5, pawn d3 can be weak in some variation. It's interesting that after more or less correct bishop b3, of course there are many moves, rook e1, h3, a4, but after bishop b3, it's interesting to tell that Fresinet against Tivakov didn't play d5 because after takes, takes, white has choice between rook e1 or h3 and then rook e1. to avoid bishop g4. So because of this, Frescinet against Tvekov played d6, and after natural c3 to avoid knight e5, he respond d5 now. This explanation that after taking, Tvekov played knight d2. After taking and rook e1, bishop f6 is possible, and now if knight d2, black has knight f4, and this is idea to provoke c3. But okay, at the game, Tvekov didn't take on d5, he played knight d2, he was better, but Frescinet won nice games, but not because of opening. So, doesn't play c3 immediately, according to modern theory, it's not so good, because d5. I played this, takes, takes, rook e1.
Had you prepared this system for black before the match? Do you remember?
Yes, but I didn't expect at c3, okay. I thought, okay. I thought that bishop b3 is better, c3 is that I consider it before the game like inaccuracy from white, and I didn't expect it really. So he played rook e1, and now my pawn is attacked, and I play bishop g4. Okay. Of course, this possible move with idea if white will play primitively g4. Knight e5, takes, takes, knight b6, and or even c6, and then prepare f5, so it can be excellent, at least excellent compensation for the pawn. But also a very reasonable move was knight b6 here. And if bishop is attacked, if bishop b3, I can play bishop f6, and important that white has not knight d2 and queen of d3. So if bishop b5, I can play f6, and it looks like completely okay for black. So probably knight b6 was more precise. So I played knight g4, and Yudasin didn't play h3, but played knight d2. Quite solid move. That's important. To play knight d2 immediately, because if white plays knight d2 here after h3, bishop h5, black has idea knight b6. And now if bishop b5, f6. And also possible bishop b3 is more or less forcing variation. Bishop d1, knight d3, bishop b3 with equal endgame. So bishop b5, f6, and if compare, if here I am trying to play same, now of course bishop b5, f6, and now d4 is coming. Takes.
Because there's no bishop f7 after
queen b3 check. Yes, queen b3 check, king h8 or rook f7, knight takes d4. Also position is far from clear. Pawn structure is better for white, but black has two bishops. King h8 is possible, even rook f7 is possible. If knight d4, queen d5, somehow black has contraplay. So, sure. So it was possible to play knight b6 now, but I decide to play king h8. I'm just waiting, so probably I expected something like h3. Bishop h5, and now if g4, bishop g6, knight e5, takes, 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 I have choice, c6 or knight b6, or probably even knight f4 now, although knight e4, about knight f4, I'm not clear, sure, because knight e4. So if taking g2, I don't know, but knight b6 or c6 and then f5. So, but a4, it's very good positional move. So he's fighting against my knights. It's clear that my knight on c6 is quite passive because good pawn on c3. And now he wants to push a5, and another my knight will have no square b6. So good play. F6, a5, logical. Rook b8. Okay. Need to do something.
Why did you play rook b8? To play b5?
Firstly, to protect pawn, if queen b3, to have knight f4,
sure.
To have pawn protected, it's quite important.
Yeah, that was the threat, actually. He was threatening queen b3.
Yes, yes. Queen b3, because after a5, I'll also have no knight a5 after queen b3. So rook b8, more or less logical. Knight f1. Oh, was possible h3 first, and then after bishop h5, knight f1. Okay, white has quite pleasant position because my knight not so good. Okay, knight f1, completely normal move. White has no direct threats, but not so easy understand what black should do. If to play queen d7, in some moment bishop b5 can be unpleasant. So I played bishop e6. Okay, usually this move is dangerous in view of d4, but immediately d4 I have knight takes c3. It's quite simple trick. So queen a4. Okay, it's possible.
What's the idea of bishop b6, Vasil? What's the idea? What's the plan?
Probably I just didn't see what exactly I should do in this position, and sometimes maybe I had feeling that the bishop can be attacked from a4 with queen. For example, if to play b5, more or less connected with rook b8 takes, if I takes with this pawn, and this. And if, and queen d7, bishop d5, bishop is hanging. Yep. Bishop f3, queen c6. So it's quite tricky position. It's not so simple. So maybe because of this, I decide to move with my bishop. Queen a4, no, logical move, but of course not only in this position. Black has white has good choice. Knight g3 completely possible. Queen e2 completely possible. So white is slightly better objectively. Okay, queen a4. It's one of the possible moves. a6. So now, before of this was more or less positional game, but now it can be more tactical. For example, white has choice. Bishop a6 is possible, it was in the game. Also, d4 is, of course, quiet move like knight g3 is possible, but interesting line is d4. And if b5, more or less natural, he take. Queen c6, important if bishop d7, queen e4, so bishop takes c4 with idea bishop d5, but knight e3, bishop b5, queen e4, and it looks like better for white. But after g4, b5 it's not only my option, I can play bishop g4, it's contraplay.
Now surprising move to play bishop g4, though.
He's taken, I can take, and knight e5, and good contraplay because his king side has some weakness. Although position is unclear, for example, takes, bishop e2 somehow, then f4, or rook d1, so it's very complex position.
Sure.
So d4 was interested, but he took on a6. So, of course, now if rook a8, he has bishop b7. Rook a5, queen c6, and my bishop is hanging. So knight a5, this trick was...
Vasil, do you remember before you played a6, you must have been calculating bishop takes, of course?
Yeah, yes, yeah. D4 I was calculated, and of course, was calculated also.
Did you have any, just before we continue, before in your preparation with Levin, what kind of player was he, Yudasin? Was he more tactically dangerous or strategic? Were there any sort of clear...
More tactical,
yeah?
Yes. Yes, as I remember. Aha, also, some interesting moment after d4 was e4. As I remember, if rook a4, b5. Now, if takes, takes, if takes, bishop d7. This also was possible. Mm. Something like this. So position is quite rich. Mm-hmm. So b5, yes. White has, if queen d1, knight takes c3. So e4 is also possible. So it's big space for calculation. So bishop a6 was played. Of course, as I told before, completely normal move like knight g3, just improved position.
Or he could play a move like queen a2 maybe, no? Something like queen a2?
Yes, also for bishop g8, more or less force it to avoid knight e3. Okay, knight g3, why not? Mm-hmm. So objectively, white is better in this position. Maybe it's not a big advantage, but it's much more pleasant to play for white. So a6, bishop a6, knight a5 was queen a5, rook a8, knight b6. Important intermediate move. I'm not taking bishop immediately because rook is hanging. If take, rook a6, black has extra pawn, although black has typical good compensation because of strong bishop. But okay, I decide not make pawn sacrificing. It's important that after knight e5, I have now b takes a6 with piece up. Not immediately take knight because queen a5. My bishop, two bishops is attacked.
So knight b6, you threaten c6, no?
Okay, maybe bishop d7, okay, and I'm just waiting. So bishop e3 more or less natural to connect rooks. Bishop d7, queen b3, ba6. Okay. So pawn structure looks better for white, but black has his trumps, two bishops, and probably bishop c6 can be considered like more threat. Okay, it's a complicated game. Okay, if white want to simplify positions, completely possible, looks takes and to play d4. And after taking knight d4, more or less equal. If bishop c6, white can take. Knight d2 is also possible here, but take, f bishop f3, take, and take. And black hardly can exploit this weakness because white pieces is quite active. Rook d1 is possible, and rook e5 also possible. Knight is good. If there will be some check, knight will go to g3. So it was completely logical position. And of course, knight g3 was completely possible too, but he played d4. It's more or less leads to complicated game. e4 logical, knight d2, f5. But d5, it's possible, but of course, black has threat to win the piece. f4, it's quite primitive, and because of this, white can consider moves like f4, or bishop f4. Both of them was quite interesting and leads to complicated game. d5 also possible, right? Leads to sharp.
What would happen after bishop f4, for example, just quickly?
Bishop f4, okay, I have choice. Maybe bishop d6, takes, takes. It's one of possibility to prepare f4 in some moment.
Sure.
So f4 was quite logical for positional reason, because if you have two knights against two bishops, it's a good idea to make position closed. So because take, knight f3 hardly good for black, will be good square e5 for knights, and if not take, position becomes more closed, so, which is quite good for, quite acceptable. But okay, I can a5 and a4, so in complicated game.
Or maybe g5.
g5, I'm not so sure, knight g3, and maybe my knight, it's a little bit strange for attacking king side. So he played d5, rook b8. So I'm trying something tactical. So I have seen idea to attack b2 pawn. So my idea probably was if rook takes a6 to play knight a4 and then take on b2, knight d3. Of course, it's excellent for black, and white should avoid this. But a very reasonable way was to play a5 with idea to push a4, and if c4 to have bishop b4 even. Mm. So it was quite reasonable alternative. But I played rook b8, queen a2. So now, if knight a4, rook b1, it's a complicated game. So I played bishop f6. I'm not so sure this is a good move. Probably was a better idea to play knight a4. If rook b1, knight c5, I want knight d3, takes, takes, and then to have two bishops, and then try to attack on f2 in some variation. So after bishop f6, I'm not sure if this was a good move, but in the game it was successful. Rook d1, it's a bad move, I can think, because it's more or less clear that black wants to play knight a4, and in this case rook will be useful in b1, so...
But in general, black has a good position here, yeah? It looks to me...
Complicated position. Yeah. I'm not... It's mutual chances, double-edged position, yeah. Okay. So white has choice. F3 is possible, F4 is possible. Rook b1 prophylactic move was quite reasonable to prepare c4 and to protect weak pawn. So rook d1, not good. Knight a4, knight c4. Of course, rook b1 was possible, but this, it's not so easy to admit his mistake. So knight c4, bishop b5, and now I have some initiative, and it's important, knight d2, queen d5. Mm. It doesn't work. Yeah. So knight a5, and now I'm utilizing bad knight from tactical reason. Knight b2, he should take, if not take, a knight coming to d3, bishop f1. So I'm clearly better, but of course white has some drawish chances. But also Yudasin was in time trouble, which helps me. In this position, the best choice for white was bishop c5, and then take on a6. But he played queen a6 immediately. I played bishop c3, quite unpleasant move, because after rook e2, I have a pleasant choice between f4 and f3, and also queen h5. So rook f3, objectively was better, of course, bishop d2. If I'm taking and rook b6, black has extra pawn, but white still fighting for a draw, because rook f1 is very passive. f4. Objectively, probably rook f6 was strong, but I played f4. Of course, now he should play bishop d4, but he played bishop a7. But he was in big time trouble, so now f3, it looks like black threats are decisive already. Queen c7, rook a7. He resigned because after taking queen h5. So it's made. So 2-0. Mm. And then third game.
So far the match is very much going your way, right? Two wins without too many problems so far.
Okay, second games was quite difficult. Okay. First games he collapsed just in the opening. So in first game I played g3, now I'm changing my strategy.
Were there lots of spectators, Vasily, for this match? I mean, where did you play, Enrico? In a big, especially in the chess club or in a theater or something? The venue, do you remember the venue? Where did you play?
Yes, I remember it was some military occasions.
Yeah.
Yes, but it was a hotel, I don't remember, Rizzene.
In a hotel?
Yes, in a hotel, but near Ministry of Police, something like this. It was some politic occasion.
And many spectators, many people coming to watch.
Okay. It's, Lithuania is very famous country.
Latvia, yes.
Latvia or Lithuania. Okay. It's a famous country with his chess tradition from times of Mikhail Tali.
Also.
Well, always were many spectators during the game. So knight f3, I decide not repeat Benoni with g3 second time. B6, g3, bishop e6, b3, d5. Of course, according to theory, it's more solid line for black, bishop b4, bishop d2, bishop e7, but you doesn't choose more risky line. Takes. King f1, and now black has choice. So bishop d6 is possible, but bishop d6, I played the game against Paul Motvani in Chess Olympiad after the match, and played knight d2, which was a novelty at that moment, and won nice games.
After bishop d6, yeah.
After bishop d6, I played knight d2. So c6, I remember last year was excellent game. Nana Dzagnidze won with black against Alexander Fier.
In this tournament?
Yes, in Gibraltar. That's it was right, c6, yeah. Knight c6, takes, takes, something like this. Takes, takes, f3, rook d8 somehow, something like this. More or less. And black won nice game. But my opponent played knight d7, knight c4, c6. Of course, strategically, black is not so good because pawn structure pieces a little bit strange. But white has king on f1. It's also some problem for white, because if game will be open, and it can be important. So bishop b2. And now b5. Okay. Timman against Karpov played castle first. Knight d2. B5. Knight e3. And more or less complicated game. But my opponent played b5 immediately. I start to think. Of course, I can play the same knight e3 and then knight d2, but I decide to change itinerary of my knights. So I play knight cd2, bishop b7, knight c3. I have threats, knight takes b5. And now knight ce4. Castle. Castle looks like very natural move, but I think it's very bad move, because white has strong positional threat, a3 and bishop e7 b4. And because of it, in my opinion, a5 was correct to prevent this. If, for example, a3, bishop e7, knight c5, takes, takes, bishop c5, bishop g7, rook g8, and then knight d7, position is completely unclear. Of course, after not take, because knight e4, but knight d7, if knight e4, even long castle, okay, it's sharp game. Probably objectively white is better, but it's quite complex game. Or queen c2 now, or knight e4. After castle, a3, and before black, without contraplay, a5, knight c5, and now all is passive, rook d8, bishop f3. So my program is more or less finished, and now I want just to improve my king.
Looks like a disaster for black.
Yes, yes. Takes, takes, knight a6, queen b3. So it's important to avoid some tricks from d-line. So e5, takes, takes, And type of position is changing, but now black has problem, because if take with bishop, rook a6 is coming. If take with knight, e6 can be quite unpleasant immediately after changing the rook. So he played knight b6, knight e4. Probably now he should take with knight, but probably he was afraid knight d6 after takes. Probably he was afraid something like this. Takes, takes, knight d6, takes, takes, knight d5. But it's maybe not so easy, because black has ideas with knight c4, so it was objectively best choice. Because knight d5, it's looks too much. Three black pieces want to take my pawn. So my pawn doesn't worth so much attention to his modest person, to her modest person. Knight d5. Bishop b2. Okay, now it's a position quite bad already for black, because white piece is well coordinated sometimes. Knight d6 is coming, or e6, or even knight f6. So bishop b4, rook ac1. Okay, it's question. My rook looks quite good on a1, so very logical looks rook hc1, for example. I don't know why I choose rook ac1. Probably my idea was to put another rook to d1, or probably in some variation I wanted to utilize my rook with h in h1 with idea h4, knight g5 to attack. But in the game, everything finished very quickly. Now, correct move was bishop e7, more or less, but white is clearly better. Queen b6 is mistake, queen c2. It's a good move, because now I'm attacking the pawn. C5, it's disaster, knight d6. So, and now I'm changing. And e6, and queen e4, and he resigned, because I have too many threats, even not only take, but queen e5. So 3-0. And
I thought you said this was a tough match, Vasil.
Huh? Yes, but it was really tough. good result, but it was not so easy to play many good moves. And this fourth game was quite tough. So, classical Spain, bishop b7. So, at the oldest time, if you remember, Yefim Petrovich Geller was popular system here to play h6, d4, rook e8, knight d2, bishop f8. Then Igor Zaitsev discovered that knight g5 is not dangerous for black, and it's possible to play without h6. And I played, and Zaitsev system, bishop b7, d4, if d4. He played d3, but while I am explaining this, I will show. So this is Zaitsev system, and idea of Zaitsev, if white play aggressively knight g5, rook f8, so of course knight f3 is the best choice now, but if white plays f4, black can take, takes, knight a5, wants to take the bishop, bishop c2, knight d5. This is very important tactical trick. And after taking, bishop g5, queen h5, h6, it's clearly better for black, because pawn is hanging, and also important here that knight has square on c4. Okay, but after this, many games was played, Zaitsev system, and everybody knows that knight g5 is not dangerous. And once I played against Vugar Gashimov. It was a little bit differently.
You just died, Vasil, yeah? Very sad. Vugar, he died.
Yes, of course recently. I know this. Okay, it's very sad news, but I want to tell about this game. I played castle against him. It was in Astrakhan FIDE Grand Prix tournament. Okay, now if c3, I can play d5, so my opponent decide to avoid this. He played h3, bishop d7, d3, d6, a3, knight b8, knight d2, knight d7, knight f1, rook e8. Okay, knight g5 never dangerous, so, but he played bishop a2. And I started to think, but okay. I had illusions that knight g5 not coming, never. And I calculated variation bishop f8. If knight g5, d5 takes h6, knight e4 or knight f3, bishop d5, everything is okay, and played bishop f8. Of course, now correct move was h6, because after bishop f8, I made move and almost immediately have seen big mistake in my calculation. Of course, Vugar played knight g5, and I realized that after d5 takes, I cannot take, of course, twice, because takes and queen h5, as I have seen. But after h6, knight e4 is not necessary. White has better move, much better, knight e6. And so, if you play bishop b7 and rook e8, please check again knight g5 sometimes. So I played in the game rook e7, but after f4, this position is quite unpleasant for black. Because if to play d5 now, immediately he can just take and d4 after taking. If to play c5, his idea to play c4, and sometime he can just improve position. Knight g3, idea knight f5. If d5, knight f5. If g6, f5. It's very unpleasant. Like, white has excellent attack for nothing.
Sure.
So I played h6 here, knight f3, played d5. Probably c5 was objectively better. But anyway, it's big advantage for white. I played d5, he took. Took, bishop f4, and then e5, and I lost very quickly this game. So knight g5 sometimes is important. But in this game, I played rook e8. h6 was possible, and Yudasin played knight g5. And now he played knight d2. f4 was possible, but...
Sure, what happens on f4?
Okay. So I have choice. I can take immediately, or I can play knight a5. It's, for example, if I take immediately, he can take knight a5. Now white has choice. Bishop c2 is possible, and also knight f3 is possible. For example, takes to play this position. Complicated position. For example, if knight d7, knight d2, and if f5, knight d4, it's coming, this idea, knight e6. Probably to avoid this knight a5, more precise. And, okay, if, for example, now bishop c2, knight d5, and of course, if take, bishop g5, excellent, is fine for black, but only because of weakness pawn g2 after takes. There is difference. Knight has no square c4, but after b4, bishop takes d5, or queen takes d5, is attacking. White can try also after knight d5, queen h5. It looks like more precise. h6, only move. E takes d5.
And why not knight f6, Vasil?
Oh, okay, knight f6, white can come back to the queen, to e2.
Sure, okay.
Okay, maybe knight d5, take everything and b4. So queen e2, if knight f6 is... Okay, queen d1 is move repetition. Queen h4 also maybe even possible, although looks a little bit dubious. H6, knight f3, knight d5. So queen e2 looks logical. With idea if knight d5 now takes and then before. But maybe it doesn't work. I'm not so sure. Maybe also maybe it doesn't work because takes takes before bishop d5. And with idea rook e8 again attack g2 pawn. So maybe knight f6 was possible also. But h6, it takes d5. So of course now I should take this pawn because if take this bishop, I am just losing my knight after changing in before. So I should play this pawn and then I will take on d5, but position it's very unclear, for example. Even simple bishop a3, if d4, f5. So bishop e3, bishop takes d5, knight d2, white has excellent compensation for the pawn because... so in this exactly situation, it was possible. Okay, not clear, but possible. So he played knight d2, more quiet, and now, okay, now I have comfortable game, h6 I can play everywhere. And now according to modern theory, more popular plan, knight g3, bishop f8, d4, and more or less standard position, knight h2, it's also possible. d5, queen f3, this was idea of knight h2, and now okay, black has white choice. I took on e4. It was a reasonable idea to simplify positions.
Maybe c4 here, yeah?
C4 was possible. C4, maybe knight g3. Maybe it's possible to play some waiting move like bishop f8. So, big choice. I took the pawn and play knight c4. This idea used Oleg Romanishin successfully, transfer knight from knight a5 to d6 against Mikhail Tal. So knight g3, knight d6, but objectively white is slightly better here. Because bishop on b7 a little bit misplaced, bishop e3, now if knight c4, rook d1, so queen c7, knight g4, queen g4. Now white has threat take on h6 and black cannot ignore this with bishop f8 because take bishop c8. Now queen g5, rook e6, it's good for black, but knight f5, unfortunately. So I should defend from this king h8. a4, okay, it's... White is slightly better, but not easy to create something concrete in one flank. So rook d1 was completely normal move, but after rook d1, rook d8, and I am just waiting. So a4, white want to make something in the queen side. Bishop f8, more or less normal move, h4. Of course, white has many big choice. Bishop c8. I want to improve my bishop. Queen h5. Okay. Some move later, he played queen f3. But probably now he wanted to prevent bishop e6 in the view. My pawn e5 is hanging. So rook b8. He took. And now he played queen f3, probably not the best way, but if, for example, rook ed1, more or less logical, I can consider now bishop e6. If queen e5, bishop b3. Although it's not so clear. Not so clear even because bishop h6 takes and queen takes e5. Well, of course, bishop e6 is not only move, but rook d1 was logical way, and white still pressing. It's, it's not so pleasant to play with black. Queen f3, and now bishop e6. Now I'm solid, knight f5, queen c6. Of course, possible move. I have a lot of alternatives. For example, rook a8, rook bd8, but I am trying probably to give my opponent illusion that I'm threatening to something, takes and takes on f3, and to spoil pawn structure. But rook ed1, and now I understood that this is not the threat, because after changing pawn structure is good for black, but white pieces is extremely active, and this is not good for me. So I changed my plan, rook a8. It's quite reasonable. Rook takes a8. It's questionable, because now more or less clear that only white chances in king side. So probably was reason to play rook b1.
Keep the rooks on here.
Yes.
Okay.
But it's not easy, because, for example, after rook b1, probably I have more reason to take on f5 with knight. Because here I have bishop e2, and okay, it's important to understand that drawing this game was completely acceptable for me.
Of course, yeah.
So he took, and he played queen g3. It of course important that it doesn't work any sacrifice. If bishop h6, I have bishop f5. So white wants to do something. Okay, now there is direct threat, rook takes d6. But of course it's not so difficult to see them. So knight c4 I played, bishop c1. I played queen c7. Of course it's not only move, no? But for example, it looks tempting to penetrate with rook to a1, but even such variation is possible. Rook d8, rook wow. c1, king h2, and now suddenly there are some threats. Bishop f5, rook takes, king h7. If rook takes, queen g6, so bishop g6, so takes. And after rook c2, rook f7, white wins. Of course, black should play queen f6 with unclear game. I don't know what is this. It's difficult to understand who is better. It seems that I'm not completely sure now, but it seems that I consider something like this during the game and decide that after queen f6 is unclear, and also after rook a1, rook d8, it's not only a way for white, also they can consider sure. prophylactic king h2 with idea rook d8. So I decide that no reason to play rook a1. So I played queen c7, very accurate move to protect e7 and protect e5 pawn. So h5. Probably more reasonable was king h2 now, because in some variation rook can go to a1, and it's very useful to unpin this rook. But, so now I prefer king h2. Well, position more or less equal, I think, already.
How long is it since you looked at these games?
Sorry?
How long since you last looked at these games? Have you looked at these games recently? These games from this match?
Yes. I prepared for election.
Well, I know, but are they still fresh in your memory, these games, these positions, or?
More or less, but okay, I refresh everything in my memory, so king h2 was better. And I understand, as I have seen, games of this match was annotated for Chess Base by Rogers, by Schussler also.
Mm. Okay. Not by you. You didn't annotate them.
No. Oh, for chess base, no. H5 I played before. Of course, black has white choice. Rook a1 was possible. But if rook a1, king h2. And this idea, bishop h6 in some variation. H5 before. And before of this, game was more or less quiet and positional, but now suddenly everything became very concrete. For example, he took on b4 and played bishop b3. Of course, quite logical to play bishop b3 without taking, not to activate black queen. But now this variation is possible, which not so easy to calculate. And it looks like white's attack is extremely dangerous, but queen d8. And if bishop takes, king h7, and nothing happened. If knight takes, okay, maybe even f6 is possible, but also queen king h7. If knight e6 takes, it's impossible because of knight, but queen e7, and it looks like nothing. So this is problem of bishop b3. And now he took, and suddenly there is some very concrete problem for white, because bishop are in danger. Sometimes rook e1 is coming. According to Schussler, now the best choice for white was knight d4. Bishop d7. Okay, knight d4 with unclear games. It was his annotation by Schussler. And after bishop b3, I played rook a1. And now Schussler again wrote that knight d4 was the best way for white.
Do you agree with him or not?
I will tell now. So I have some questions here, because according to Schussler, bishop d7, quite natural move, is bad, because knight c2, if knight takes b2, queen is f3. It's excellent intermediate move, this idea to take on f7 or take on a1 and then take by queen. But I am not completely agree with him, because if now knight d4, in my opinion, bishop d7 is the best. According to Schussler, bishop d7 is bad. But after knight c2, I'm not agree, because take on b2 doesn't seem me like only move for black. So my proposition is rook b1. And I don't know what to play. I want just to improve my position with bishop e6. For example, if queen f3, now bishop e6. If now bishop e2 with idea to trap my rook, I have knight d2 and then take. If immediately bishop a2, I have knight takes b2. So don't know. It looks like everything is fine for black. It's important that after queen f3, I have knight d1, and if queen f7, b3. Everything okay. So, okay, I didn't check with the computer, but okay. It looks like everything should be okay. Oh, even if something wrong with rook b1, I have option like rook a7. So it doesn't look like I can pretend for advantage at least. So. But he played king h2, and this is blunder. I took and played knight a5. Of course, now he played bishop d2 is desperation. Bishop c2 is desperation. Bishop d2 was possible, but position is extremely unpleasant for white after simple take. Schussler now consider only rook d1, bishop d1, queen d6, queen g4, and it's okay, it's unclear, but more easy take on b3, and now, in my opinion, the best for black to play e4 check, king go somewhere, or g3, just take, and queen d7, okay, with advantage for black. Okay, probably one white can make draw with some suffer. But only black can pretend. Okay, now it looks like queen e1 more or less easy draw. But okay, but at least there is no danger for black. But so after bishop d2, after bishop c4, c2, I'm just winning. I just take, rook d1, queen f5. So it's important to see queen yes. g6 nice. And mate.
Just show us, just show that. Yeah, we see.
So if, for example, this, this, king h6. And mate. Important with this pawn, not with another pawn. So, but okay, it's. I wasn't in time trouble, so it was not difficult to see this. So queen f5. Now g6 is well protected. Bishop d2. Now, of course, there is many ways to win. Knight c6 was reasonable, but I choose good one. And my idea, if he's taking, I can check and win the queen. So bishop e1. Rook d1, f3, knight. Okay, now it's white is completely hopeless. Okay, many ways for win, but I choose one of them. Okay, so here is, and okay, 4-0, and last game was in match, I white, so next game, how to put, next game. I was white, and draw was enough for me. There you go. So, knight f3 again, c5 now, d5, d6, Benoni. D6 became more popular now. The reason is that after takes immediately, takes and d6, of course white can play knight c3, but also e4 is possible. Takes is impossible because queen a4, and then black white can start bishop d3, castle, and probably knight will go to d2, c4 in some variation.
Not in c3. Yeah.
So, but okay, it's also playable for black. So, g6, he is not hurry with taking, e4, bishop g7, h3, bishop d3. He took finally to d5. Of course, some players, like for example, Armenian Artashes Minasyan, likes to play knight a6, waiting moves, and only after castling to play e5 to close the position and exploit that now g4 is not so logical. Without castling, g4 would very logical. But now g4 it's not so logical, then knight h5, it's some typical more or less king's Indian contraplay. But he took, I took with c pawn, another very popular line as take with e pawn, and after rook e8, bishop e3, bishop h6, castle, and takes, and queen e7 is the best for black according to theory, but taking the pawn is can be considered like suicide because queen d3, queen d2, and then queen h6, knight g5 is. Yeah. Extremely strong attacks, but I took, he played a6. Of course, b5 is theory, but after b5, it's many variation withdraw, which wasn't acceptable to my opponent. For example, something like this. Castle, and now knight b6 or knight e5, but okay, white is playing without any risk, so. If white wants draw, it's no problem for them. So a6, a4, knight h5. It's popular plan with knight h5, but usually players started with knight d7 first. Knight d7 and only after castle. Of course, white can play bishop f4, but after bishop f4, it's possible queen e7. And after castle, knight h5 now. So after castle, knight h5. So because after castle g4, it looks dubious, and then black wants to play knight e5. It's a complicated game. He played immediately knight h5. Of course, now I also can play castle, knight d7, more or less the same. But I decide to play bishop g5, more direct way. Bishop f6, bishop e3. Knight d7, it's quite logical, and now I want to improve again my knight. But immediately knight d2, it's not so good because black has pleasant choice with bishop g5 or bishop d4. And good contraplay. So bishop e2, I want to prepare knight d2. And now my opponent, I think, made a serious mistake. So I think, probably not now. He could play knight g7, but rook e8, normal move, knight d2. And now he should play knight g7. It was only way to continue the game because now knight c4, it's not dangerous for black because knight e5 is possible and knight b6 is possible. And if to play castle, this is a position quite unpleasant for black already. Especially if he need to play his fovin. Idea is if bishop d4 takes is possible and then knight b1, but much more simple to play knight c4 and take with knight. So in my opinion, here was much better, at least for practical reason, to play knight g7 immediately. And now if knight d4, knight d2, bishop d4, it's much more reasonable. Because if now knight c4, he taking and f5, and rook is on the correct place. So rook e4, knight d2, and now, okay, knight g7, it was the best, but after castle, knight c4, not castle is correct, with quite pleasant position for white. Bishop d4, knight c4. So bishop d4, it was another miscalculation. I just took.
Well, he needed to win the next four games in this match, right? He's 4-0 down.
Yes,
so.
Yes, but okay, at least try one. But now it's very bad for black. Okay, he can take my bishop, but after simple queen takes h5, I have extra pawn and much better position. So he played queen h2. Probably he missed my idea, g3. And now takes on h5 with queen is complete desperation because takes, takes, and knight c4. So sure. He took and king e2. It's a quiet move. My king escape. Okay. And black has nothing. Of course, it's not possible to take bishop because of rook g1. If knight e5, I have important move queen g1. And attacks is finished. So queen g2, knight d3. Check. If knight c4, I have even queen e2. So this finish it. Okay, now my opponent offered a draw because white is completely winning after knight d1, but okay, draw was acceptable to win the match. So it was in Riga. Maybe somebody has some questions. I can respond.
Anyone? Thank you, Vasil. Any? Well, very interesting. Yeah.
So,
who did you play in the next match, Vasil, after winning against Leonid?
I think it was useful to analyze this, so it can be useful for my next match. I don't know when I will play, but I hope to play.
What happened in the next candidates match after this one? Do you remember who you played?
Sorry?
It's in 1991, in the following match, what happened?
I lost against Artur Yusupov in tiebreak.
Yeah.
So then I played some matches against, but not candidates. I played against Jan Timman, against Vishy Anand and Linares. So
what do you think about the old format of the candidates like this, best of eight games, for example?
Well,
you quite
completely normal. I think quite interesting. Mm-hmm. So as you can see, okay, a score was big for me, but game was quite interesting. Mm-hmm. Many interesting things which is possible to learn.
Yeah, you said about your coach was Felix Levin at the time. Yeah, did you and he did you keep working for other matches and other tournaments?
Okay, I didn't see him during a lot of times. So last times I have seen 1 year ago in Lviv, in the cafeteria. Okay. But okay, in next match he was also my second.
When you played Yusupov, yeah? Yes, he was still your second, yeah.
And when I played against Anand in 1992, he also was my second.
Mm. You mentioned at some point Yefim Geller. Mm-hmm. Yeah, did you and he ever do any work together? Did you play him? Did you know him?
I never played against Yefim Geller, of course. But I have seen him, okay. Mm. But okay, of course, it's excellent player, very theoretical player.
Yes.
Mm. So, of course, for young people, it's very useful to study games from Soviet strong grandmaster, not only Yefim Geller, also like Alexei Suetin, Isaac Boleslavsky, Rashid Nizhmetdinov, Anatoly Lutikov, many others.
Okay. I'm sure we have some questions from the audience here. Who would like to start, sir?
I have two questions. Mm-hmm. Firstly, on a number of occasions you said objectively white is better or objectively black is better, and to be honest I couldn't tell who was better, so I was wondering how do you make that assessment? Is one of the most difficult things to do. And my second question was, on several occasions you said there were two or three good plans, he could have done this, I could have done this, I could have done that. Well, how do you make a choice when you've got two or three good plans? How do you go about making a choice out of the three good plans? You have to choose one. How do you make a choice in practical terms?
Okay, so I told objectively white is better. But what I wanted to tell that objectively white, my opponent, was better, but situation was not so pleasant for him. Not because chess reason, but because, okay, score is bad, okay, position is looks like better, but nothing concrete. So and this is not comfortable situation. And how to make choice? Okay, it depends of many things. First of all, of course, your clock. Second, it's how you feel yourself. Also important, who is your opponent? You can utilize advantages and disadvantages of your opponent also. So, and of course, all each new games it's a new history. So Julius Caesar,
Julius Caesar
once when somebody asked him what is the best happiness in your life, Caesar gave answer. It's the freedom of choice. Hmm. It was answer of
freedom of choice.
Yes, but okay. It was vision of Julius Caesar. I don't think that for everybody it's the biggest happiness in the life. for many people, it's a big problem to make choice in many situations. But okay. Okay, Julius Caesar was quite unusual person.
Sir, you had a question?
Yeah, do you feel this was the cycle that you had the best chance? Because Yusupov went on to play Timon, I think, and he lost. And Short was the time that he defeated Karpov. So at that time, perhaps, you had won Linares in 1991.
Yes, and also after the almost immediately after match against Yusupov, I won a very strong tournament in Reykjavik World Cup. So and after this, I won a match against Jan Timman. It was a friendly match in Holland, very interesting match, in my opinion. Probably next time I will describe six game match. But okay, probably. But okay, I cannot see big reason to have complained about past time. So I feel myself with a lot of energy now, and I hope that my best chance is in the future.
Okay, that's good. So 1991, yeah, you won Linares ahead of Kasparov and everyone.
Yes.
So you don't, in a way, that was kind of your peak. I mean, do you think or not? Or you had later peaks as well.
Yes, maybe later will be.
Yeah, or still to come.
Yes.
Yeah. A question, sir?
Do you ever have anything to do with the Dane Bent Larsen?
Yes, I played against Bent Larsen, but only rapid chess in the Amber tournament.
Okay.
And it was a very memorable for me story, first Amber tournament. Before the last round, I was half point behind Vishy Anand. And I played with black against Pickett. Anand played with white against Bent Larsen, who was in last place. And Bent Larsen win easily with black against Vishy Anand. And then it was two sessions games, and I waited what is the result. Bent Larsen win against Vishy Anand. And after this game, Larsen explained that for spectators that Vishy is too young and has... puede decir en español, no sabe cómo hacer tablas.
Doesn't know how to make a draw.
Yes. At that period, it was 1992. And I started to play against Pickett, and I won this with black, very sharp games. With variation was, I will show, it was Queen's Indian.
This was rapid or blindfold?
Rapid. No, it was no blindfold at that time. That tournament. It was variation g3, bishop a6, knight d2, bishop b7, bishop g2, bishop e7, e4, sharp line takes, knight e5, this line.
Sorry, you white or black vessel?
Yes, I won with black. I won with black.
You're black against Pickett, yeah?
Yes, yes. This line it was, and a very complicated game, and and finally I won this. Position was completely unclear.
Do you remember almost all your games of your whole career?
Okay, more or less remember. Okay.
Yeah.
of course, not from first move to the till the last, but openings, result, main ideas. Yes, I remember.
Fantastic.
Do you think you have the best memory of the chess professionals around?
I don't know. I think many good players has good memory. For example, Anand has excellent memory. Gelfand has excellent memory. Gary Kasparov has excellent memory. Probably also not so famous players has excellent memory like Viktor Gavrikov or Igor Rausis. They know a lot of
theory
also international languages, foreign languages.
Okay,
more than 10 foreign languages.
The question at the back, sir. Yes?
Is there one player that you have always found more difficult to play against than any other? Not the best player, but more difficult.
Good question.
Sorry?
Is there a player you've had particular trouble with who's been problematic for you, you know, whether you had a bad results against or...?
Okay, each strong player is problematic for me. But it always changes, and sometimes you are playing good against some board, then situation changes. Sometimes you are playing bad, then situation changing. For example, Geller and Smyslov. Firstly, Smyslov won almost all games, then Geller won almost all games. So for me, of course. Okay, last year I lost all games, almost all games against Caruana, but okay, this year I hope to improve this.
Do you have any special memories of Vugar Gashimov? We spoke about him earlier. You played him several times? Or?
Yes, many times I played, yes. Last time I played against him in Vacanzei, I won with black in Pirk. Mm. And before this, I lost him four games in a row, something like this. One of them I showed this. Mm-hmm. And it was 3 days in the tournament. As I remember, it was 18th of January. Yes, I was in a panic because I'm losing him all games, what to do, no ideas what to play. And my second, Orest Gritsak, suggested me, okay, Vasily, forget about chess, let's play drafts in the site www.kurnik.pl. And I start to play drafts.
Before your game with Vuga?
Yes, in the 3 day. It's a playing day, I didn't play drafts, but in 3 day I spent many times to play in drafts, and next day I was in quite good fighting spirit, decide to play Pirts, and successfully win this game. Yes. But okay, it's pity that it was my last game against him.
Against him, right, yes. Okay. Yeah. Any other questions, sir? Yeah?
Regarding playing drafts, the Times said that this a draw? It's a forced draw by
No, I don't think so. Okay.
There are different kinds of drafts, yeah? Different rules, different...
Yes, okay, but even 64? Okay, 100 drafts, it's much more complicated, but even 64 Russian version or Brazilian, my feeling, it's not such drawish game. For example, in my practice, very poor number of draws in my practice. So, okay, I spend sometimes with study theory of drafts, of opening, but it's difficult to imagine that everything is possible to remember, if to know much more than I know. Of course, I'm not professional. So I think it's like myth. It's fantasy that this is everything drawish. Okay, in chess, the same things also was happen sometimes, so it's draw. Also, I want to describe one of my idea. Maybe can be interesting for somebody. For example, many words in the world is about fighting against draws. So rules of Sofia, 30 move.
Even
rules.
Here we have a rule, Vasily.
Yes, I know, yes. already I know. 30 move or 40 moves, always different. Mm. And last year it was in Ufa, was World Championship drafts, 100 drafts. And in 100 drafts, it's quite familiar that if you have two kings against one, even if you long, strongest side has long diagonal, it's not enough for win. Okay, there are some traps, but professionals knows this, and Okay, so three kings and against one king is draw.
Three against one?
Yes. In 100. In 64, three winning if long diagonal strongest part has. So, and the situation is quite often happen. Mm-hmm. So, and at that championship was used interesting idea. If somebody at the end has three kings, opponent has one, so it's draw, it's 1-1. So if somebody wins, 2-0 in draws, in draw, 1-1. But it's draw, but who has three kings, one with plus. Opponents has one with minus. Right. And if in the final some players share at place, it's
like can be info.
It was a system for groups, four players, and from each two players qualified it. So it was quite situation quite possible. And okay.
You think it could be used for chess?
Yes. I tried to think, is it possible somehow to use this for chess? And I think I find the idea. What is possible? For example, okay, it's not for Swiss tournaments, it's more for Robin tournaments, especially double Robin tournaments, like last candidate tournaments in London, mm-hmm. eight players to two games against each other. So in chess, there is a rule of stalemate. So it's possible also situation. If you are making stalemate, you have a half point with plus. If you have no moves, it's draw, but you have half points with minus. And this is excellent stimulation to play long game, because, okay, by composition it's possible stalemate after 20 moves, but in normal games, more than 40 moves you need to play to make stalemate.
Yes.
And for example, sometimes you can see that there is no winning chances, but it's possible to fight for stalemate if it's possible. Mm. For example, if even king and pawn, it's always possible to make stalemate if king cannot take pawn immediately, even king and h pawn. Always possible, so it can be good stimulation for to play longer game. Mm. Oh, but okay, I don't know if somebody will consider it seriously, but this is my idea from parallel world drafts.
Mm. Have you tried other games like, for example, Go?
One my friend from Sweden, Emil Hermansson, tried to teach me to play Go, then Shogi, but I understand that it's something not expectable for me.
Backgammon?
Backgammon, I have played this short backgammon with taking. Yes, oh, but okay, it's just I'm played this just for fun.
Lennart, you have a question?
Yeah. Draws is first played on the black squares of the board.
Yes.
Do you think you improved by studying draws? Did you think you improved to play on the black squares in chess as well?
I never had such idea, but I hope I will be able to play also in white squares quite good in the future. Sorry, bridge? I never tried to play bridge. From cards, I tried to play preference, belot, but just for fun.
Do you have any questions, Leoncio? Maybe you have a question? Okay. I would like to ask you, Vasil, just if you've got time still. You mentioned before Julius Caesar, and I think last year we had a talk here in the masterclass, and you talk about some books you'd been reading, books or writers you like reading. Do you have anything you're reading now or anything?
Yes, now I'm reading Boris Akunin books. Names is Turkish Gambit.
The Turkish Gambit?
Yes.
All right. Like a thriller or what?
About Turkish war, okay. Mm. So quite interesting.
And what about chess books? Do you ever think about writing a book of your best games or your autobiographies? Are we ever going to see Vasil Ivanchuk's autobiography?
Maybe, okay, but I'm playing quite a lot, so I have not too much free time. So, mm-hmm. Well, but maybe in future. We'll see.
Any final questions from the audience before we wrap up? No? Okay, well, Vasil, thank you very, very much for your time, and a big round of applause to Vasil Ivanchuk.